Hey, Lorehounds, it's Cooper here inside Turbine's booth once again. I'm with Fernando Paiz, my good buddy, who does the executive producing of DDO. What's the big stuff we got coming for Update 11?
Well, Update 11 is pretty huge. Our fans are really looking forward to it. It's going to have a new class.
It's always monstrous.
That's the big cool new goodie, is the Artificer class. It's an Eberron-specific class in the D&D rules. So it's us taking the Eberron lore and some of the stories that we've had in the game for a long time and bringing them to life here, first with the Artificer class, but then also with House Cannith, which is a new public area that we're introducing into the game, the House Cannith Enclave. House Cannith is one of the powerful dragon-marked houses in the world of Eberron. They are the Artificers, right? They are the engineers of the world of Eberron. They create all the cool technology that makes the world so different from some of the other settings.
So the Artificer, is that going to be one of the paid-for classes?
Yeah, so the way that we're doing the Artificer is that you will be able to unlock it with House Cannith favor, but not with Update 11. So
it'll be a later update you can actually unlock it?
Yeah, actually with Update 12. So you'll be able to do it this year, you know, a couple months after Update 11 goes live. We plan to bring Update 12 out.
So behind us, we got the Artificer, and this is obviously the GM-approved version.
Yeah, exactly. I get to cheat, which is cool. But this is a level 20 Artificer behind me, but you can see a lot of things about her that are pretty cool. One thing is that she has a pet. My pet's named Scrappy. You have an Iron Defender that you get to summon starting at level 1, and you get to improve him and customize him.
And they actually visually change, right, as they level?
Yeah, they visually change as they level. They start off pretty small. Also, the stats change, which is, of course, something that our players really love, is to customize the stats about their characters. You can slot in armor and a weapons module, which will actually give your Artificer different clickable buttons over here on their control bar. They have a control bar similar to Hirelings in our game. This is the beginnings of a pet system for DDO, which you can imagine eventually us doing other popular classes, like the Druid, for example, which is a longtime player request. But don't try and ask me when that comes out, because I'm not going to answer.
What's her gameplay like? I mean, we see here she's got a crossbow and then some sort of awesome bracelet.
So the general gameplay, they're one of those jack-of-all-trade classes that get to do a little bit of all kinds of different things, but they also have some unique abilities. So one notable thing is that they get to imbue items with magical powers. That's something no other class can do today.
Is that a permanent effect?
No, it's a temporary buff that they can apply. So it's a type of buff that's new to the game that you'll be able to do for weapons and armor, and the Artificers can do that exclusively.
A little class support there, and then we got some DPS mechanics.
Yeah, so they're a support class in that regard. They also are excellent at ranged combat. I've chosen to make my Artificer here ranged focused. So right from level 1, they get the repeating crossbow available to them. So that's really fun to get to blast stuff through the early parts of the game with your repeater. And then they have this really cool offhand weapon, which is also a ranged weapon. And it's called a rune arm. I'm going to start charging it right here. So you can see she's charging up her bracelet thing. And as you achieve different levels of charge, you can see a reflected on the bracelet, different parts of it light up, and it does a lot more damage. So if I turn it around over here and just shoot over in this direction, you can see if I charge it to 1, it fires 1 projectile. If I let it charge up to 4 or 5, it's going to fire that many projectiles, and each one also lands harder. So basically, it's your big
spread damage, but more damage too.
Yeah, these will actually home in on a target too. If I had a target and I was here in an adventure area, you'd actually select an enemy, and you can shoot all your rune arm shots right at that enemy.
So she's effectively a dual wielding class.
Exactly. That's our first type of dual wielding. So if you do like ranged combat, this is actually our most fun ranged class right now. I know rangers out there will be upset with me for saying that, but
you just started a thread.
Oh man. We'll get there. Well, think of it as she's got some great stuff that eventually we can pick back to the rangers as well.
What else do we have? I mean, the new class is a big thing, but there's also a new adventure pack. Where are we going in the story with that?
Yeah, the adventure pack is really bringing to life this House Cannith Enclave and the backstory that they have. I'll walk around here a little bit and let you see it. As we were talking about, House Cannith is the technology powerhouse, right, in the world of Eberron, and we really want that to come to life in the way that you experience this enclave, because this is where these guys live. And if I wait around, a levitator, which is one of the House Cannith technologies, will make its way over here and I can take a ride. But you can imagine the possibilities for future content to basically make them make players be able to do all kinds of things from...
I'm thinking of future puzzles.
Exactly. Some kind of cool jumpy puzzles.
Wow, that looks gorgeous.
To drive our players crazy later. One of the secrets, the adventure pack is called The Secrets of the Artificers. The core big secret of the Artificers that not even all House Cannith knows is that down below here, there's an ancient creation forge.
What about dungeons? How many just normal dungeons are there?
We have 3 6-man dungeons, 1 large high-level wilderness area, and 2 12-man raids.
So it's going to be a pretty big addition.
It's a pretty big adventure pack for us. All that together, especially again for the players that like the endgame raiding, yeah. It's huge for them.
So update 11 is coming September 12th.
September 12th, yeah.
And we can get our hands on one of these awesome crossbows.
Absolutely. You can play your Artificer like this with the range guy. They also make pretty good melee guys too, because again, you can always get a sword, buff your armor, and go in and tank.
Thanks so much. It looks great.
Sure, thanks.